Good morning, all of you. Welcome to wifistudy.com, one-stop destination for all competitive exams. My name is Munesh Sharma, and today we present you another topic of static GK, that is the important dams in India, in English. In our previous video, we uploaded this video in Hindi, and today we are going to present this topic, that is important dams in India, in English. Look, friends, there are more than 3,200 major and minor dams in India. Okay, till 2012. So we don't need to remember all these dams. We just go through the important dams in India. Okay, friends, if you want to prepare from the application mode, then you can download our Wi-Fi study app, and that will provide you daily current affairs GK test in Hindi and English, both format. You can download it from the Google Play. If you have any query or doubt, or you want to make a special video for your upcoming exam, you can email us at support@wifistudy.com. So friends, slowly and slowly we covered all the topics. Okay, and today we present this topic in English. That is the important dams in India. As I told you before also, that there are more than 3,200 major and minor dams in India. Dams plus barrages, but we are not going to through all these. We are going through only the important dams in India which will come in your exam or previously came in your exam. Okay, we will start from the North India, then we'll proceed to the center, then we'll to the south, and after that Northeast region of India, as we did in our previous videos. Okay, so let's start from the JNK. And you only need to remember only the important dams in India. Okay, I will tell you who are the important dams and what you need to remember about it. The first is JNK, Jammu and Kashmir. In Jammu and Kashmir, you need to remember five dams. Okay, which are the important dams? First is Baglihar Dam. Look, friends, only the two important questions that can be only the two questions that can be framed from the important dams in India section is, first, they can give you the name of the dam, and they will ask you about the state, which is the state have this dam. Okay, second, and they will ask you about the river, on which river this dam is constructed. These are the only two questions that can be framed from this part of the story. Okay, we will cover both the sections. We will look the state in which the dam is constructed and the river on which the dam is constructed. Okay, so first, Baglihar dam is constructed on the Chenab river. Okay, Chenab. Another is Dalhasti hydroelectric plant. This is also constructed on the Chenab river. Chenab and Jhelum, these are the two important river of the JNK. Okay, so out of the five, you will get the three on the Chenab. First is Baglihar, second Dalhasti, third Salal hydroelectric project. This is also constructed on the Chenab river. Okay, fourth, Kishan Ganga. Look, friends, Kishan Ganga, the name is there is a difference between the Ganga and the Kishan Ganga. Ganga river did not related to the JNK, but still this dam named Kishan Ganga is constructed in JNK. Okay, so you need to remember, you don't need to confuse about this, that if a name comes from the Ganga, then it will be from Bihar or Uttarakhand somewhere. Okay, Kishan Ganga dam is constructed on Kishan Ganga river, and this is in JNK. Okay, and another is Uri dam, it is on Jhelum river. As I told you, Jhelum and Chenab are the two important river of JNK. This is constructed in the Baramulla district, and this place is located near the LOC, line of control. Okay, Indo-Pak border. Okay, so five important dams of JNK are, first, Salal, Baglihar, Dalhasti, fourth Kishan Ganga, and fifth Uri dam. So these are the five dams that you need to remember from the JNK region. Okay, we'll go from slowly, we'll cover all the states of India. In some states, you only need to remember is like 2 or 3 dams, that's it. Second, another important state is Himachal Pradesh. In Himachal Pradesh, there is an important dam named Bhakra Nangal Dam. Okay, Bhakra Nangal Dam. So, Bhakra and Nangal, these are the two different dams. Okay, these both are situated in the Satluj River. That's why we named it together, that is Bhakra Nangal Dam. But Nangal is situated in the downstream of the Satluj and Bhakra is above it. And Bhakra Dam is the highest gravity dam in India with 226 meter high. And there is a one Govindsagar reservoir made on it. This is also important that you need to remember the important reservoir. Also, name of the important reservoir. Okay, so the Govindsagar reservoir is constructed on Satluj River near Bhakra Dam. This is a reservoir. As you can see in this photo, this is the reservoir. This is the dam which is constructed and a reservoir is made. Okay. So, this is the important dam in Himachal Pradesh, that is Bhakra Dam. That is another important dam, that is Maharana Pratap Sagar Dam. Maharana Pratap belongs to the Rajasthan, but the name of the dam is from the Himachal Pradesh. You need to remember this. Maharana Pratap Sagar Dam. It is on the Bias River and the another name is Pong Reservoir. Okay, this is the one of the sites of the 26 wetland sites declared in India by the Ramsar Convention. Ramsar is a place in Iran and there is one convention of wetlands. Okay, out there, and there are 26 wetland sites in India and one of them is this Pong Reservoir. And another name of the Pong Reservoir is Maharana Pratap Sagar Dam. It is situated in the Bias River. Another is Pong Dam. Previously was the Pong Reservoir and this is the Pong Dam. This is also constructed on the Bias River. You can see in this picture. So only the three important names from the Himachal Pradesh you need to remember. First is the Bhakra, second is the Maharana Pratap and third is the Pong Dam. Okay friends. And firstly, this is made in the Satluj River and the last two is on Bias River. Let's go to the Punjab. Punjab, you only need to remember single name, that is the Ranjit Sagar Dam. Ranjit Sagar Dam. Okay, so this is an important name in Punjab, Ranjit Sagar Dam, and this is made on Ravi River. Okay, this is constructed on Ravi River. So, Ranjit Sagar Dam is in Punjab. Uttarakhand, you need to remember is the Ram Ganga Dam. This is on the Ram Ganga River itself. Okay, there was another name like Kishan Ganga Dam. You don't need to confuse about both these names. Kishan Ganga Dam was in JNK and that was constructed on Kishan Ganga River. This is Ram Ganga. Ram Ganga is constructed in Uttarakhand. Okay. And another is the Tehri Dam, very important dam, Tehri Dam. It is on Bhagirathi River. Bhagirathi River. There is one glacier, Gangotri Glacier. You heard about this name previously also, Gangotri Glacier. From the Gangotri Glacier, there is a river originated, that is the name of the river is Bhagirathi River. On this Bhagirathi River, there is one dam named Tehri Dam. And there is another river, that is the Alaknanda River. Alaknanda River. When these two rivers meet at the Devprayag, from that place, there is a formation of another river named Ganga. Okay, from the Devprayag, Ganga started. And these two rivers met in the Devprayag. Okay, so Tehri Dam is in Uttarakhand. So, you only need to remember two names from the Uttarakhand, that is the Ram Ganga and the Tehri Dam. From Uttar Pradesh, you need to remember some name. First is the Chittorgarh Dam. Chittorgarh is a district in Rajasthan. From Chittorgarh, Maharana Pratap is a person who belonged to that place. I am telling you this because this usually confuses the student. Okay, Chittorgarh Dam is not constructed in Rajasthan, it is constructed in Uttar Pradesh and it is on the Ganga Basin. So, you need to remember if a word Chittorgarh Dam come in your exam, you need to remember that it belongs to the Uttar Pradesh, not Rajasthan. Second is the Govindsagar Dam. Govindsagar Reservoir Previously I told you that Govindsagar reservoir is on Bakra dam. Okay. But the Govindsagar dam is constructed in the Uttar Pradesh. It is on the Sehjaad river. You don't need to remember the name of the river. Okay. But you need to remember that the Govindsagar dam is constructed in Uttar Pradesh. Third is Sirsi dam. You don't need to remember the Bhakra Nala. It's a small stream out there in the UP, and the important name of the important dam is the Sirsi dam. You need to remember this, Sirsi dam. Another is the Chandra Prabha dam. Chandra Prabha dam is constructed in UP and it is made on Chandra Prabha river. Okay. So Chandra Prabha dam. And another is the Rihad dam. Rihad dam is a tributary of the Son, and Son is a tributary of the Ganga. Okay, so it's a reservoir. The name of the reservoir which is made on the Rihad dam is the Govind Vallabh Pant Sagar dam, and it is on UP MP border. Okay, so you need to remember that Rihad dam is constructed in UP and the Govind Vallabh Pant Sagar reservoir is also made in the UP, and it is the name of the reservoir of the Rihad dam is Govind Vallabh Pant Sagar. Okay, so all these are the dams which are belong to the Uttar Pradesh. First is the Rihad, then Chandra Prabha, Sirsi, Govind Sagar dam, and the last Chittorgarh dam. Okay, the five dams belong to this category, and you need to remember about all these things. Now we'll go to the Bihar. From Bihar, you only need to remember single barrage and single dam. First is the Indrapuri barrage. It is across the Son river, also called the Son barrage. It is across the Son river. That's why it is also known as the Son barrage. Indrapuri barrage, situated in the Bihar. Second, Durgavati dam. Durgavati dam is constructed on Durgavati river. Okay, so you don't need to remember the name of the river. Both are same. So from the Bihar, you need to remember the Indrapuri and the Durgavati. Indrapuri and the Durgavati, these two names belong to the Bihar. Now Rajasthan. Rajasthan, there are more than 225 dams, but you need to remember nearby 4 or 5 dams from the Rajasthan. First is the Bhopal Sagar dam. Look, this is a place in Madhya Pradesh. Bhopal is the capital of the Madhya Pradesh, but you don't need to remember that the Bhopal Sagar dam is from Madhya Pradesh. Okay. Bhopal Sagar dam belongs to the Rajasthan. You don't need to confuse about these things. You need to remember all these things. Okay. Bhopal Sagar dam is in Rajasthan. You don't need to remember the name of the river. Second, Bisalpur dam. Very another important dam in Rajasthan. Bisalpur dam. It is in Tok district. And it is made on Banas river. There is a river in nearby the Sawai Madhepur and the Tong district of Rajasthan. Bilaspur dam belong to that place. Chandrabhaga dam. Chandrabhaga. As I told you, Chandra Prabha dam is in UP. And Chandrabhaga dam, which is made on the Chandrabhaga river, it is in Rajasthan. Okay. Fateh Sagar dam is also in Rajasthan. So you don't need to remember the name of the river. Harishchandra, a person known for his honesty. Harishchandra Sagar dam, it is also made up in Rajasthan. Jawar Sagar. So you can easily recognize the Rajasthan dam as there is a more than two or three names belong to the Sagar. Okay. Like Jawar Sagar, then Harishchandra Sagar, then Fateh Sagar. Okay, all these are the names belong to the Rajasthan, and Bhopal Sagar. So if you get a name from Sagar, the probability from the Rajasthan answer must be from Rajasthan is 90%. Okay, so you can recognize Rajasthan dam from the Sagar word. Jawar Sagar and the Kanota. Kanota dam is made up in Jaipur, and you can see it's a very beautiful place and one of the tourist places of Jaipur. You don't need to remember the name of the river. So, and another is the Rajsamand dam, Gomti Banas river. It is on Gomti Banas river, another tourist place. Rajsamand dam. Okay, it is in Rajsamand district of Rajasthan. So and another is the Rana Pratap. Rana Pratap Sagar Dam. It is on Chambal River and it is also in Rajasthan. As I told you before, Maharana Pratap Dam is in another state and Rana Pratap Sagar Dam is in Rajasthan. Okay. I told you before also that there is another dam named Maharana Pratap Sagar Dam and that dam is not belong to the Rajasthan. In Himachal Pradesh, you will get the name of this. Okay. This is the name another that you don't need to confuse about. That's why I made the slide back because I want you to remember the difference between the two dams. That is the Maharana Pratap Sagar Dam. It is in Himachal Pradesh and Rana Pratap Sagar Dam. It is in Rajasthan. Maharana and Rana, it is the only difference between these two dams. Okay. This dam is made up of Maharana Dam is on Bias River and that dam is on the Chambal River. Very famous dam of Rajasthan. Okay, from the Rajasthan state you need to remember a few names. That is the first is Bhopal Sagar, then Bisalpur Dam, then Chandra Bhaga Dam, Fateh Sagar, Harish Chandra, Raj Samant, Jawahar Sagar, Kanota Dam and last one Rana Pratap Sagar. So there are few dams in Rajasthan you need to remember. Okay, from the center exam point of view, I will tell you the important name of it. We made this slide for your both the exams like state board exam and the center board exam. But from if you are preparing only for the center exam like UPSC, SSC and all these, then you don't need to remember all the dams of the Rajasthan. You only need to remember is the Bisalpur and Fateh Sagar. These are the two important dams that you need to remember for your center exam. That is first is the Bisalpur Dam and second is the Fateh Sagar Dam. Okay, but if you are giving the state board exam, then you need to remember all the seven names of the state of these dam. Okay, and from the Madhya Pradesh, there is a Gandhi Sagar Dam. Okay, Gandhi Sagar, Indira Sagar. If you get a name like this, Indira Sagar, Gandhi Sagar. If a name of the family Gandhi come in exam, okay, you need to remember that this is belong to the MP. Gandhi Sagar Dam is made on Chambal River. Another is the Omkareshwar Dam. Omkareshwar Dam is on Narmada River. Okay, Narmada River, the origin of the Narmada River is Amarkantak. There is a place Amarkantak in Madhya Pradesh. The origin of the Narmada is from this place. And Omkareshwar Dam is in MP, not in Gujarat. Okay. Another is Indira Sagar Dam. As I told you, Gandhi, Indira, if a word like this will come in exam, you will easily remember that this will belong to the Madhya Pradesh. So Gandhi Sagar Dam is on Narmada River. Okay. So these are the three important dams you need to remember from the Madhya Pradesh. Omkareshwar, Gandhi Sagar and Indira Sagar Dam. From the Gujarat you need to remember a few names. That is, first is the Sardar Sarovar Dam. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, very famous person, Iron Man of India, belong to the Gujarat. Okay, so if you have Sardar word come, you will get the answer from Gujarat. This is also made on Narmada River. There are more than 500 dams in Gujarat. So you need to remember 4 or 5 names from the Gujarat. Okay, first is Sardar Sarovar, second is Sabarmati Dam, Sabarmati Ashram. Everybody know about the Sabarmati Ashram. So Sabarmati Dam is in Gujarat. And it is made on Sabarmati River itself. Kandana Dam, very important dam from your exam point of view. Kandana Dam, it is made up on Mahi River. Okay. Mitti Dam, it is also made up on Mitti River. Ukai Dam, there is a one Uri Dam, URI, which is in GNK. URI. And this is Ukai Dam, it is made up on Tapi River, another name is Tapti and it is in Gujarat. So you need to remember few names from Gujarat, that is Ukai, for second Mitti, then Kandana, then Sabarmati, then Sardar Sarovar. All these names belong to the first Second, Mitti, Kandana, Yukai, and last one is Sabarmati. Okay, so these are the five dams that you need to remember from Gujarat. So now Chhattisgarh. In Chhattisgarh, you need to remember two names. That is, first is the Gangrel Dam. It is made up on Mahanadi River. Okay, Mahanadi River came from Raipur. The origin of the Mahanadi River is from Raipur district of Chhattisgarh. Okay, and there is a famous dam on Mahanadi River is Gangrel Dam. It is also known as the Ravi Shankar Sagar Dam. Ravi Shankar Sagar Dam. Okay, Ravi Shankar. So if a word Ravi Shankar comes, you will get to remember that this is belong to the Chhattisgarh. And second dam is Dudhwa Dam. Frequently come in exam, Dudhwa Dam. It is also made on Mahanadi River. So the two dam belong to the Chhattisgarh. Both made on Mahanadi River. First is Gangrel, second is Dudhwa. From Jharkhand you need to remember a few names. That is the Palna Dam. Firstly, Palna, it is on Kumari River. You don't need to remember the name of the river, but this is made in Jharkhand. Palna River, Palna Dam. Second is Methun Dam. So from the Chhattisgarh, you need to remember, from the Jharkhand, you need to remember two names. That is Palna and Methun. These are the two dams. Now West Bengal. You don't need to remember the dam in West Bengal. The very famous name from the West Bengal is the Farakka Barrage. It's a barrage across the river Ganga, located at the border of the India and the Bangladesh. Okay, Bangladesh. That is frequently this Farakka Barrage will frequently ask in the exam, and you need to remember that this is belong to the West Bengal, not the Odisha. Okay, the students are confused over this question. So Farakka Barrage is in West Bengal. Now Odisha, very important dam from the Odisha, that is the Hirakund Dam, and it is made on Mahanadi River. Okay, Hirakund Dam, very famous dam of India. This is in Odisha. And another from the Odisha is Indravati Dam. It is made on Indravati River itself. And these are the two names you need to remember from the Odisha. First is the Hirakund Dam. It is made on Mahanadi River. Firstly, as I told you before also, that origin of the Mahanadi River is from the Raipur district of Chhattisgarh. Okay. And second is Indravati River. Now from the Andhra Pradesh. First name, very famous name from the Andhra Pradesh, Nagarjuna Sagar Dam. Friends, the probability of asking the river and the dam from Indian states is more from the Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. Okay, these are the three states which are very important from your this part of the story. Okay. So first is the Nagarjuna Sagar Dam. It is made on the Krishna River. Second is the Sri Salem Dam. Okay, this is also made on the Krishna River. The three important South Indian rivers are Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri. Okay, the origin of the Godavari is from the Trimbakeshwar. There is a place named Trimbakeshwar in the Nashik district of Maharashtra. Okay, and these two rivers, that is Krishna and Kaveri, the origin of the Krishna and Kaveri is from the origin of the Krishna is Mahabaleshwar. And the origin of the Kaveri is Brahmagiri. This is a place in Karnataka, Brahmagiri. Okay, so you need to remember the origin of these three rivers also. Godavari, the origin of the Godavari is from the Trimbakeshwar. Origin of the Krishna is from the Mahabaleshwar, and the Kaveri is from the Brahmagiri. Okay, so in Tamil Nadu, first Nagarjuna Sagar Dam is on Krishna, Sri Salem Dam is on Krishna. Okay, so you only need to remember the two names from the Andhra Pradesh, that is the Nagarjuna, and second the Sri Salem Dam. From the Telangana district, you need to remember that Nizam Sagar Dam or Manjira River. Nizam Sagar Dam is on Manjira River. Okay, and this is a tributary of the Godavari River. Manjira Dam is a tributary of the Godavari River, and this is belong to the Telangana. So from the Telangana, that is the 29th and the last state of India, Telangana, Nizam Sagar Dam is made in Telangana. Okay, on river Manjira River. You don't need to remember the river name, but you need to remember that Nizam Sagar Dam is made in Telangana. Now Maharashtra, first is Kona Dam, very important dam. Kona Dam is on Kona River. Second, Sukhna Dam is also on the Sukhna River. Third, Godavari Dam, as I told you, Godavari, the origin of the Godavari is from Maharashtra. So the Godavari Dam is also constructed in Maharashtra. And the name of the river is Dharna River. You don't need to remember the river name. And another is the Bhima Dam. Ujjaini Dam or Bhima Dam. It is also made on Bhima River. So these are the few names from the Maharashtra. You need to remember, first is the Koyna, then Sukhna, then Godavari, and then Bhima. These are the four names that you need to remember from the Maharashtra. Okay. So in Goa, there is a dam named Salulim Dam. Salulim Dam, very famous dam from the Goa, Salulim Dam, and it is made on Sangoim River. Don't need to remember the name of the river, but you need to remember the Salulim Dam is in Goa. Okay. There are few other places in the Goa like Morjem, Mandolim. So this lim is frequently used in the Goa. So Salulim Dam is in Goa. Karnataka. First very famous important dam is Krishna Sagar Dam. It is on Kaveri River. K for Krishna, K for Kaveri, and K for Karnataka. Okay. I told you Krishna Kaveri, Godavari, Krishna Kaveri. So Krishna Sagar Dam is on Kaveri River, not on the Krishna River. You need to remember this. Okay. And this is in Karnataka. Tungabhadra Dam, very another famous dam, Tungabhadra Dam on Tungabhadra River, and this is a tributary of the Krishna River. Tungabhadra is the tributary of the Krishna River. Okay. So these are the two important dams from the Karnataka, that is the Krishna Sagar Dam, another the Tungabhadra Dam. Now Tamil Nadu, very famous and important for your exam, Amravati Dam. Amravati Dam is on Amravati River. Okay. And it is in Tamil Nadu, Amravati Dam. Another important, Methur Dam. It is also on Kaveri River. The name of the reservoir is Stanley Reservoir, which is made on Methur Dam on Kaveri River. So Tamil Nadu, you need to remember, first is Amravati, second Methur, and third Vegai Dam. It is on Vegai River and it is belong to the Tamil Nadu. It is not belong to the Kerala. Okay. Don't confuse over this. So three dams you need to remember is Amravati, Methur, and Vengai. These three belong to the Tamil Nadu. Now Kerala. There is a very famous dam named Idukki Dam in Kerala. Idukki Dam in Kerala. Okay. This is only the arch dam of India. You can see this is the arch dam of India. Only and first arch dam of India. And it is made on Periyar River. Very famous river of Kerala. Western flowing river. Okay, it will not go towards the Bay of Bengal. The river which will merge in the Bay of Bengal are Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri, Mahanadi. Okay, and the western side of the river, western flowing river are Narmada, Tapti, Sabarmati, Mandovi, and Periyar River. Subarnarekha, all these rivers are western flowing rivers. Okay, so you need to remember the eastern side and the western side of the river also, where they go. So Idukki Dam is on Periyar River. Malla Periyar Dam, very famous dam. This is famous because of the dispute between the Kerala and the Tamil Nadu government. Okay, in few exams this question came in a different format, as the question is framed like Mellua Perua Dam dispute belong to the which two state, and the options that came was Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka. So the correct answer is Tamil Nadu and the Kerala is the two dams which are having a dispute over this Malla Periyar dam. Okay, it is also on the Periyar river. Both the Kerala dam is on Periyar river, important dam is on Periyar river, and the dispute is something like that in 18th century. The place where this Malla Periyar dam is belong to the Kerala. Okay, but the king of the Kerala at that time gave this land to the Tamil Nadu government, okay, to the Britishers for the 199 year lease. And now the Kerala Tamil Nadu government want to raise the dam to more height, but the Kerala government want to restrict this dam height to the same height. Okay, so this is a dispute which is going between the Tamil Nadu and Kerala from few years. So Malla Periyar dam belong to the Kerala. Now Northeast India. In Northeast region, you only need to remember two or three dams. First is Subansiri lower dam. Subansiri is belong to the Subansiri river, and this is made in the Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Okay, Arunachal Pradesh, border of the Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Subansiri. So this is belong to the Subansiri river. Second is the Ranganadi river, and the dam is, name of the dam is Ranganadi dam. It is also made in Arunachal Pradesh. So these are the two dams, both important dams of the Northeast India, and both are made in Arunachal Pradesh. First is the Subansiri, second is the Ranganadi. So friends, these are the important dams of India which are important for your exam. Okay, so you only need to go through these dams, and the probability of exam of the question frame can be framed from this is 99.9%. Okay, so be smart about your hard work, and best of luck from Wi-Fi study team. Hope you will succeed in exam. Thank you.